much for that. Amit is also now joining in from Edelweiss. Amit, I mean, you've been bullish and you've sounded bullish for a while in the space. They say gains beget more gains. In a way, it sort of builds on into a momentum as more and more people want to get onto the winning trade. But are underlying fundamentals as strong as they were a couple of months back?
Well, in December, I recall that, we wrote a note, Unseasonal Spring, in which we found we were a little bit amused by the strength in steel prices, particularly because of the supply crunch. And then we wrote a note, Dream Run, in January, in which we expected that, this will extend till Q4 FY21. But the major thing that is now moving the steel prices and stocks up is essentially the implementation of production cuts at Tangshan. Now, one has to understand that in past we have seen instances when Chinese government has come up with endeavors, but only to backtrack. But this time around, it seems that their carbon emission targets are too stringent. They want to meet carbon emission targets earlier than what they have promised. So, to that extent, the production cuts have been implemented in Tangshan, and that would reduce steel production by 22 million tons approximately, as per our estimates for this year, CY21. Now, this 22 million tons might not seem to be huge in the overall context of a steel industry, but in terms of seaborne market, there is no country that can replace that 22 million tons. That is point number one. Point number two, if you look at US and Europe, prices are not only at 13-year high, but also have breached the level that was seen before GFC. And there, the supply crunches are so acute that our channel checks indicate that in Europe, the tight situation can continue well into Q4 of CY21. So clearly, we are seeing a long run, and we can only take step by step because, these policies can be typically very unpredictable. If tomorrow Chinese government decides, for example, that they would loosen these carbon emission thing a bit, then you will immediately find prices and stocks retracing back. But as of now, from the booking data we have for May and June, we believe that Q1 FY22 would be possibly the best quarter that we would have seen, at least, in last so many years. It will be a record quarter for almost all the companies in the space.
Okay, that's interesting. Amit, can you talk a bit about the valuations? Because, steel stocks go through their own cycles, and in the past, we've seen, names like Tata Steel trade at even 1.8, 1.9 times forward price to book. Of course, today it's trading at a lot lower. Can you talk about the valuations, where they stand currently, and how much higher can they go, and if you could compare it with the previous cycles?
Yeah, sure. So valuations, when you have brought price to book into context, I would actually start with EV/EBITDA. So valuation is again, a very contextual thing. So far, consensus has not really upgraded its estimates. So for instance, if you look at consensus estimate for FY21 for sale, the implied Q4 is a decline of 22% QOQ in EBITDA. So this is something that consensus is stuck with. And the moment, moment consensus or the street increases estimates, these valuations would recalibrate. Now, having said that, it's very, very unusual to see in commodities that you get peak profitability and peak valuations. But the moment consensus recalibrates, I would say that I would be, as per my estimates at least, Tata Steel would be trading at, for example, 4.5 times FY22. But then my estimates are like almost 15-16% higher than the street. So clearly, valuation is a matter of time. The moment after this result season, people will revise their estimates upwards. You will find this valuation thing sorted out. On price to book, yes. Steel stock, Tata Steel, for example, is trading at 1 time, JSW higher, even SAIL is trading 0.6 times. And we find that some of these stocks, particularly SAIL, if you look at last averages, I mean, last like 5-year average or 10-year average, it's trading a lot higher. But also look at ROE. ROE of Indian metal, Indian steel companies is much higher than global peers. So globally, steel stocks are the ROE is 8.5%, but for Indian steel players, it's in double digit. So clearly, you know, if the ROE is higher, the valuations would only tend to be richer. So that way, it is justified at this point in time.
Just one last brief comment. Great thoughts there, Amit, as always. Should one wait for a pullback to get in to in these steel names? Because you said, I mean, valuations and prices don't peak out at the same time. So what should one do? I mean, should if you're in it for the long term, stay invested, or sort of eye the exits and be wary?
No, well, there is no, I would say there is no long-term per se in metal stock. You have to go quarter by quarter, unfortunately. Otherwise, you will be stuck with it forever. So my view is, if you are keen to make some 15 to 20% return, and this is, I'm saying from the information that I have with me now, maybe one quarter hence, we might see that steel prices might go further. But one thing one has to always remember, there is always buyer's reluctance that comes into play. And the moment that comes into play, you will find that, you know, steel prices would be peaking out. But having said that, I still see headroom. So if you are looking at, like, if you are happy with 15 to 20% upside in metal stock, that nobody is, frankly. But this is a sure shot upside, and that you will get in a quarter, definitely. So you can stay invested. You can enter even now, by the way.
Vikash, how much cheaper are the Indian steel prices vis-a-vis the landed import prices? And can you talk about the headroom there is for steel companies to raise prices from here on?
Yeah, so currently Indian landed prices ex Mumbai are still a little over $100 cheaper than the imported prices from China. And it has been the case from the past 1 month also that the Indian prices are in between 60 to 100, are trading between $60 to $100 cheaper than the international prices.
Vikash, Amit, it's a pleasure having you with us. Thanks so much for an enlightening discussion. We need to slip into a very short break, but on the other side, Macrotech Developers, which popularly is known as Lodha Developers, is attempting to go public for the third time. They're looking to raise 2,500 crore rupees. The issue opened yesterday, will be closing tomorrow. The question is, should you subscribe? Some thoughts coming in from Deepak Shenoy on the other side of this break.